Marco Rubio. There's at least one area of agreement between this Republican analyst and this Democratic strategist. South Carolina is where campaigns get nasty.
Let me respond. That's another lie. I never went bankrupt. It's another lie.
But if people were attacking Donald Trump 6 months ago, they'd be hurting themselves as well as Donald Trump. But as you get fewer and fewer candidates, it benefits them more to attack. And South Carolina has always been the part where enough people drop out that you can start attacking. So that's really what's going on in South Carolina.
Former Atlanta Tea Party chief Julianne Thompson points out New Hampshire was mostly secular, mostly white, pretty mild.
And then you go down to South Carolina, which is the South, which is far more evangelical, which it has a lot greater diversity. And also politics start to get a lot nastier as you get into South Carolina, a lot more volatile.
It's absolutely a game change. The Democratic primary is completely different demographically than New Hampshire and Iowa. It's much more African-American. The change in income is huge. It's a real change. And it's actually the first real primary because it's also fought through robocalls and on the air in a way that New Hampshire and Iowa aren't.
When some 55% of South Carolina voters are black and Hillary's expected to have them mostly on her side, that would seem to settle the Democrats' race. Thing is, it might not be that simple. Bernie Sanders is pushing hard for their votes.
If Bernie is able to start taking African-American voters, and if he can start getting Hispanic voters, because Texas is huge in Hispanic voters, then this is going to be a lot closer.
And what if black voters just don't show for Hillary or Bernie?
Black voters headed to the polls in droves in 2008 to support President Obama. But their excitement this time around seems lukewarm at best.
Meanwhile, the kids are just crazy for Bernie and his talk of revolution.
The only thing that Hillary Clinton is promising is incrementalism, and that's just not that attractive. But when you're talking about revolution, you're going to throw out the system of big money and billionaires. That's something that young people who are mostly unemployed graduate students can really get behind.
Thompson says if only they knew the real world of jobs and taxes.
Versus looking through the rose-colored glasses of college and indoctrination of college professors, I think that they're going to change their mind on socialism.
As for the Republican race, Democrat Turkheimer enjoys the possibilities.
Oh, it's a clown car, and it's absolutely enjoyable until you start thinking that one of them is actually going to be the nominee. You know, you look at Ted Cruz and Donald Trump and the sort of race to the bottom on their side, and it doesn't really say great things in my mind about America, but it should say good things about our chances in the general election.
Thompson definitely gets what's driving support for the outsiders this year.
I understand that anger. It's a righteous anger because it's based on the fact that people are sick and tired of the campaign bait and switch. They're tired of politicians who campaign one way and govern another. And that's not, that whole idea of insurgency is not something that's exclusive to the Republican Party. You're seeing that in the Democratic Party as well.
Trump and Cruz continue leading the polls, but Turkheimer is keeping a wary eye on Marco Rubio.
Rubio is actually the Republicans' most scary candidate for Democrats. He's the one who's most on point, most on message, sometimes a little too much on message. And he's the one that can really capture the youth vote, especially if he's going up against someone like Hillary. He is the person that I'm most concerned about, and he's the one I'd like to see drop out next.
If you are talking about the same old status quo, elderly, white candidates, that's over on the Democratic side. If you want youth and diversity, take a look at the Republicans.
Meanwhile, Turkheimer can hardly believe when it comes to Trump, voters don't wake up and smell the implausibility.
There is something that actually happens with politicians is, yes, they want to say what people want to hear, but they also in the back of their head think, can I govern based on this? And he doesn't have to worry about that at all. He doesn't even care. He's just like, well, I'm going to build a wall. Oh, you don't think I will? It's going to be the greatest wall of all time.
Thompson believes, though, Republicans in South Carolina and beyond will vote for an outsider because they're so sick of the moderates sold to them, like in 2008.
And then they told us again in 2012, we needed a more centrist candidate, that Newt Gingrich couldn't win in their opinion. And we got Mitt Romney, and we saw how both of those things worked out. One of the definitions of insanity is repeating the same behavior over and over and expecting a different result. To win an election, you do not run away from conservatism. You message it, and you sell it.
Paul Strand, CBN News. To go to a private clinic or go to the